New Parish brings the cool kids to sunny California for a KSJS Strong Arm Open University exclusive with me, Unsa Suhail.
Okay, let's see. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Now my turn.
Sweaters and the jeans back in 01. Daffy Duck running on the stomach of that sweater. Chicago getter inside all leather. Boy, yeah. Allow out if you know one. Talking about a shopping spree. Damn, now we on one. I'm just kidding, ain't gonna be no bag getting. Casino always throw they chips in. Throw it in the bag like the bag that the chips in. Bag after bag of that cabbage we twisting. Thinking about our existence and sticking to the mission. Could get a lot off top, or you could get that pot that you thin. Depends if you was listening. We've been to through Michigan Ave with back handles on hand and sandals on sand. Ain't a better match. Put 20 on the game, and it's plenty entertaining. I never scratch. Nah, let me bet them
this
back.
This for all y'all. Roll call. Live and state your name. It's like bust that. Who's that?
It's Charles chopping it. Don't stop. The governor, the mayor, the president, the rest of them. I'm dressed in guest jeans, pocket buzzing, text messages. Left hand rolling. Pass me the lighter, right hand jab, jaw to your
face.
Yeah,
I know. I mean, it's, I know a lot of people I look up to, man. But like, sometimes it's not about making a song with them just because you look up to them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I kind of would like to just keep it like it is with a lot of them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just want to look up to you and like your music for what it is, you know, like it's different forms of martial arts that don't mix in together. That doesn't mean that theirs isn't dope, you know what I'm saying? Just because it don't mix with yours, you know what I'm saying? So I think it's just cool sometimes to let shit be how it is and just like it for what it is and don't try to take from it. Like that's a lot of the problem of hip hop right now is everybody feel like they gotta. If something's hot, they gotta take from it. They gotta get in on it because it's hot. And even if it don't mix with what they're doing, they're like, I gotta get on it because it's hot. This guy's hot, so I gotta get a piece of it. But like that ain't what it's about, man. Like if it's not something that, you know, correlates with what you're doing, just let it be, let it exist, and enjoy it for what it is and respect it. You don't gotta always, you know, suck the life out of everything, man. So I think it's not all about just getting features from who you respect, man, but just respect them, learn from them, and like it.
Your guys' style is actually very artistic as well. How important is your image for like what you wear?
I just wear it. I'm just here, you know what I'm saying? Like what people pick up from me, it's cool, but I'm not engineering this for a reason. It's just, this is what I like to wear. And what I wore before was what I like to wear. And I kind of think that it's cool that it looks like that. And maybe the individuality sticks out. And that's awesome. But like I said, it's not like we got to make sure. I'll dress like whatever. I wore like a t-shirt and some hoop shorts. You know what I'm saying? Now it's cool today. I'm down for that. You know what I'm saying? That's just how I feel. I like to feel cool, and you know what I'm saying. I wear my threads. It's not like a fully thought out. Like we wear this and see if everybody notices. But I'm glad they notice, so I'll keep on making sure I look cool.
Yep. I mean, this is what I have on regardless. Like no matter what I was doing, I would have this on right now. You know what I'm saying? So I guess that's cool that I get to wake up and just do me and people respect it and people like look up to that shit, but this is what I was gonna do anyway. You know what I'm saying? So like it's just dope that, you know, I get to do it for a living, you know? So I don't gotta take any special effort in
you know, really think it out too much. Like, I get to just do what I was going to do anyway, and luckily it's cool enough where people like it.
So there's no pressure to be even more stylish now that you have such a large fan base who follow what you guys wear.
Yeah, like, why would I be pressured?
No, like, I've been doing this, you know what I'm saying? I've been doing this since I was, like, this big, you know what I mean? So it's no need to switch up the formula now.
Featuring, so we came up with a name for it. It wasn't like, hey, we're a group now. It was just like, when you make songs together, we gave it a name, and it was dope. It's a little different.
So you plan on doing more songs under the name P.O.C.?
I don't know. We're usually run into each other a lot, so it happens. That's how the first two happened, so I don't want to make it like, oh yeah, we're going to sit in the studio and do this like that, because that's not how it works.
Okay, so many of your fans are assuming that it's going to be a group now, you guys are going to come out with stuff, so you're saying that's not the case?
I didn't say that. Oh. I'm just saying that we didn't think about it that much. I just rather say, pulled over by the cops, this song Authority, instead of saying Chip the Ripper featuring Bondi, featuring Freddie Gibbs, featuring Chip Gamers, and she's going to watch.
Okay, that makes sense. And
you know,
then why?
I like to give things themes, you know what I'm saying? Like, why not? Like, I think people are too lazy. So I was like, yo, just name it something. So if it was a record, if it ever had a 12-inch of it, I wouldn't say featuring. We'll be able to record together for the rest of our lives. God willing, we all stay safe.
And why the name pulled over by the cops? That's where it originated?
Yeah, because it just made sense to me.
Hey man, what's good? In case nobody knew, man, this is my man Chuck English right here, man. Make some noise for Chuck. Chuck Charles right there, man. Yeah. PJ on the ones and twos back here, man. Put your Heineken in the air, man. Show them what's going on.
If PJ was a drug dealer, his name would be Manny Pacquiao. Get it? I don't know if y'all got that. But that was fun.
All right, man. And
you know what I'm saying?
What's up, dog?
I think this is where Chris Lang is.
Let them know who it is.
I'm Mikey. I rock.
Right.
I'm Mikey. I rock.
Right.
I'm Mikey. I rock.
Right. Check it. Hold the phone like a
call on the other line. I'm on the phone with a bone of another kind. So hold on, we could roll to the other side. The side of my dome is a zone you can never find. Grip hands, you might need assistance. Trying to find where you are inside of my head. Stay in line, single file if you can. Then we can kick it like kickstands. And you know I pedal to the chain slip. So fly, propel us to the angels. Repelling the fellas that's jealous of the name. It's repelling to rappers as soon as I stage hit. So 1-2-1-2, mic check. I'm out for the high end. EQ my steps. I don't use bad grammar, so please excuse this. I'm just trying to let niggas know who I is.
I'm Mikey.
Or any musician. Yeah, I don't think I would shortchange the offense to rap music. But if I could produce any song, it would be I really would love to like do something for the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Interesting.
That would make my year. That's the one group I looked up to.
Why?
They were the first rap like that I ever experienced. You know what I'm saying? It was rock and it was funk and it was like some dudes from California heavily influenced from Parliament, but they were playing rock. You know what I'm saying? And I was a drummer, and that shit kind of blew my mind because that's when I started playing to them. So.
And you got to work with Travis Barker on the song Sour Apples. Is that because of your root and rock that you wanted to do that?
That and Travis is like a really good friend of mine. And I wanted him to be on the record with us. That was like important. And we just did a tour with him in the spring. We were on the I Am Music, Still Music tour with Wayne and Travis. Like it's cool because we are homies and he is like one of the greatest living drummers of all time. Like one of the greatest drummers of all time. Definitely top like five alive.
Oh man, we love y'all, man. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Yo, it's good to be back out here with y'all, man. I promise you. We're gonna see where the real fans at with this one. Y'all ready? Let's go. Hands up.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Slow it down, slow it down.
I've seen a lot of familiar faces that I've seen at a lot of shows before out here, and that shit is love, man. Like, it's dope to see that we can grow and bring people with us along for the ride, man. So, like, the Bay Area has been one of the areas that showed us love since we started this shit, man. It's good to come back out here and get to rock with the people that's been with us since the beginning, man. Like, I've seen a lot of people that I've seen at our first few shows and shit. Like, they out here singing all the words still, and that's ill, man. Like, I never imagined that people would follow me like that when I first started, but like, that's what's happening now, and that's dope, man. I can't ask for nothing more.
And for growth, where would you like to see yourself go in the next few years? What do you expect to hear from the cool kids?
Endless shit ever, and I'm already on the way. Wherever I'm going, that's in the creator's vision. Like, I'm just doing what he wants me to do. Whatever it is, whatever that is, whatever has me where I'm at right now. I don't like to overthink shit that much and plan out things that might not be my fate. So I'm just making this music sound crazy.
Yeah, what's up? I do my